We are running out of time. We only have a few minutes left. And one question is coming through is, Paul, in Viking Shores, you referred to this operation, the Faroe Islands, is the Ferocious Islands. Can you talk more about that? Why are you calling it the Ferocious Islands? And Harry, after, I'd love to hear your reaction as well, like how the Faroese are feeling about that description of their country.
I think to drive these pilot whales towards shore, which is severely traumatizing for a long period of time, and then to drive them into the beach to then slaughter them with knives to, you know, it's a torturous, agonizing death. And I find that very, very ferocious behavior. And that's why we called it Operation Ferocious Isles.
And Harry, what do the Faroese people think about that description?
We just don't recognize ourselves in that. It's a very organized and very carefully planned and monitored thing. You need an approved whale bay. If whale bays turn out to have unfortunate killings, not so humane, they're disallowed, and you have to drive the whale somewhere else. If there's enough whale meat to go around for everyone in advance, then the whale is not driven ashore. They let it go. And even others are only driven ashore to put radio transmitters on them for scientific research. So Mr. Watson's point paints a much grimmer picture of the situation than it really is.
I don't think I can paint a grimmer picture than what it is when what everybody can see. And you just admitted that it's inhumane because you said that if it's inhumane, you have to go to another beach. So you have admitted that it's inhumane.